Congress launches 2016 campaign. Cashew traders trained on cashew value chain promotion. Pleasure to have you select GBC24. Time to bring you News Hour. My name is Gifty Eji. In our first story, cashew traders from West African countries have attended a master training program on cashew value chain promotion in Sunyuan. The program was designed for those in the cashew trade to acquire skills and more knowledge, especially about modern trends in the cashew business. The training was organized by Competitive Cashew Initiative with support from the African Cashew Alliance.
The master training program spearheaded by the Competitive Cashew Initiative, ComCashew, seeks to build the capacity of players in the cashew industry and help nurture experts in the value chain to facilitate knowledge exchange, learning and innovation within the cashew sector in West Africa. The four-day program was attended by 70 participants from 12 countries in the sub-region, including Nigeria, Benin, the Ivory Coast, Burkina Faso and Guinea-Bissau. In his welcome address, the Bnahafu Regional Minister, Mr. Eric Opoku, said the region was playing host to the program because it is the center of the cashew industry in Ghana, accounting for half of the total cashew production in the country. This year, the region produced 70,000 metric tons. The executive director of ComCashew, Ms. Rita Widinja, said her outfit is poised to partner the growers to increase their yield through modern methods. She urged the participants to make judicious use of the opportunity offered them to help build a sustainable and competitive industry in the sub-region.
We need that public-private dialogue. We need improved policies and regulatory services to make it a sustainable and a beneficial value chain.
A Deputy Minister for Agriculture in charge of crops, Dr. Ahmed Yakubu Al-Hassan, assured the gathering that government would continue to provide the policies and investment framework to encourage robust involvement of the private sector. He revealed that his ministry has developed a 10-year cashew master plan for Ghana, which was financed by ComCashew.
The objective of establishing the board in Ghana is to create a platform for formalized interactions between government and the private sector to implement policies to ensure the viability of the cashew business, amongst others.
As part of the activities package for the program, the participants were to go on a field trip to Wenchi, the hub of cashew cultivation in the region, for insight into modern trends of farming and processing.
It's been a year since the electronic method of collecting TV license in the country started. In an interview with the acting director of finance at GBC, Pastor Ebenezer Buche, he said the drive has been fruitful since most of the challenges experienced with the manual collection is now history. He was grateful to Ghanaians for their support and urged all to register and pay their TV license.
For decades, television license collection in the country was done manually, which came with its own challenges. After a long break, which allowed for the restructuring and modernization of the system, GBC finally introduced an all-new and effective electronic technique for collecting television license. The amount was also increased from 30 pesos to 3 Ghana cedis a month, or 36 cedis annually per set for domestic and commercial users. The acting director of finance at GBC, Pastor Ebenezer Buchi, said with the e-television license system, fees collected are easily accountable and everybody can easily register and pay anywhere, anytime.
https://www.tvlicense.com.gh. Once you go on our website, you should be able to register. If you go on the website, you'll be able to pay online via your Visa card, your MasterCard, meaning that Ghana TV license is gone international. For areas where there are no internet, and for that matter, they will not be able to go on the internet, they can use your phone. And that one too will be giving the short codes, that *718*28#. Now, if somebody wants to arrest you for not paying your TV license, the person will not ask you for a paper. They will just ask you of your phone number and key it into the system. If you have paid, it will come out. Your name and everything will come out. If not, then you have not paid.
The Ghana Broadcasting Corporation, GBC, has so far partnered 20 banks and some telecommunication companies in the country for collection. Pastor Ebenezer Botre added that more innovative ways for collection of TV license fee will be introduced soon.
Very soon, agents are going to roll out across the country. We're also going to roll out other agencies with institutions that have payment platform. We are coming down as low as paying your TV license to the mobile agents. Wherever, you can go for mobile money. In case you don't have a mobile wallet, you can just walk to a mobile agent and pay your TV license and receive your prompts.
He urged those who have not yet paid their television license to do so.
Away from that story, the Apostolic Faith Mission International at Odoko has presented assorted items valued at about 14,000 Ghana cedis to the Accra Psychiatric Hospital. The Covenant Keepers Group, a youth wing of the same church, also made a cash donation of 1,000 Ghana cedis to the hospital. The presentation was done at the church premises at Odoko in Accra. The church says the gesture is part of its service to humanity.
The Accra Psychiatric Hospital does not have enough funds to cater for its inmates and has for some time now been calling on Ghanaians and corporate bodies to come to their aid. In response to this call, the Apostolic Faith Mission International took it as their yearly responsibility to help the inmates of the hospital. The items presented included bags of rice, bottles of cooking oil and cartons of soap. The resident pastor of the church, Reverend Augustus Dakwa, presented the items to the officials of Accra Psychiatric Hospital. The director of the Accra Psychiatric Hospital, Dr. Pinaman A. Apau, was grateful and promised that the hospital administration would use the cash and items presented for the intended purpose.
I know one of the concerns or one of your concerns is that when you give to us, they do not get to the patients. But we stand here and we promise you that these are going to get to the patients and we will use them for them, just as you've given them to us. And we pray that whatever you have lost by giving to the patients of Accra Psychiatric Hospital, we pray that the Lord himself will give back to you a millionfold.
The assistant pastor, Nana Osei Krapa, also added his voice to the call for Ghanaians to remain peaceful throughout the election period. The resident pastor of the church, Reverend Augustus Dakwa, said the presentations was in fulfillment of the church's policy to support the less privileged.
It's not going to end here. We continue to do this as an example for all people out there to copy and do the same thing to underprivileged.
Now, the Living Bread Mission Lebanon Zone 4 has organized a medical screening for the Lebanon community, especially for members of the church. It was part of the church's annual convention and the 19th anniversary. The exercise was also motivated by the church's belief that contributing to community development and well-being is an integral part of evangelism. The church says the medical outreach is to complement the spiritual needs of the people by helping them to know what is happening within the physical body. The theme for this year's convention of the Living Bread Mission is Principles of Healthy Church Growth. Again, it's to watch a news hour on GBC24. Now, some political stories. The National Democratic Congress, NDC, has officially launched its campaign for the 2016 elections. Thousands of party sympathizers thronged the newly built Cape Coast Stadium for the launch. The campaign launch, according to the party leadership, signals the beginning of its journey to retain power in the December 7 election. Emphasis was also on the massive infrastructural development that has taken place across the country and the President Mahama, who the party describes as the best candidate for this year's election. President Mahama, outdoored as the flag bearer for the party, shed light on the government's achievements and what it intends to do when given another term in office.
What is ahead of you would not be an easy task. It's going to be quite a challenge, and it's going to be quite demanding. I can only appeal that you do not allow unnecessary undue provocations to create undue tension. Let's go through this campaign as responsibly as we possibly can, all the way into the elections. I will reserve what I have to say till after the elections, when I will come around the country to share with you how I think we could restore the kind of strength that can take us well into the future. There are certain weaknesses that we need to deal with. Ladies and gentlemen, let me just give you one point, just one, that I want you to take home with you. The NPP cannot be underestimated. You know it, I know it.
Every opposition party will talk about change. So change for an opposition party is normal. The change that is permanent, that is transforming Ghana, is happening. So why do you go for a change that is a threat to the stability and to peace? So we want change that transforms, we want change that improves things, we want change that is inclusive. And all those changes we are getting with John Dramani Mahama. So why change when change is already taking place?
Our focus in the last 4 years has been on three main issues. One, to resolve the power crisis. Two, to stabilize the economy. And three, to improve our socio-economic infrastructure. With your understanding and cooperation, we have put the worst of the power crisis behind us. The fast-track addition of almost 1,000 megawatts of power to our generation has enabled us to balance supply against demand. While we have done a lot in resolving the crisis, a lot more remains to be done to ensure sustainability, as we found out recently with the delay in the delivery of a parcel of light crude oil in June from Nigeria due to militant activity. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm committed to making Ghana not only energy sufficient, but to making Ghana become the hub for power supply in the whole of the West African sub-region. On this note, I declare the national campaign and parliamentary campaign for the year 2016 duly launched. I also declare the National Campaign Task Force duly commissioned. Thank you very much. God bless us all.
Meanwhile, President Mahama will from tomorrow officially begin his campaign to retain power. The campaign will start from the Western Region, where President Mahama is expected to visit 16 constituencies. Those constituencies will include Amenfi Central, Amenfi East, Pristia, Huini Valley, Takwa Elemble, Jomoro and Ahanta West. The president will climax his campaign with a rally before departing for Accra. We'll take another break and we'll bring you more stories. Stay. In sports, more than 200 athletes have participated in the JNPC Ghana Fastest Human for the Greater Accra Zone in Accra. 8 athletes booked their places for the grand finale, scheduled for September 10 in Kumasi.
Team for the 4th edition of the Ghana Fastest Human organized competitions to scout for athletes in the Greater Accra Zone. The event attracted sprint talents from the Volta, Eastern and Greater Accra regions. Athletes, both male and female, competed in the under 13, 15, 18 and senior divisions. The highlight of the event was the 100-meter heat finals for the senior divisions. In the women's category, Aida Mensa from the University of Ghana came tops. For the men's division, Paul Joseph Amoa from KNUST pulled off a major upset, beating bitter rivals Desmond Ayi and defending champion Shadrack Okoku. Both winners were delighted with their triumph.
This came by surprise, but I made it. I just told myself I have to calm down and psych myself that I can do this. And I beat those beside me. They were the best. I'm not the best.
I know this is not the ultimate, so I can't really celebrate. So when I get to the ultimate, then I'll know I'll be extremely happy and I'll know I've done a good work.
In total, 8 athletes were selected to compete in the final round of the competition. Honors were also conferred on deserving athletes. With the regional elimination rounds completed, the stage is set for the grand finale in Kumasi on September 10th, where athletes will compete for the ultimate prize.
In entertainment, the much-awaited comedy show Calibos Meet Emanuela and Mark Angel Comedy finally came to pass at the Ifwa Sederland Park in Accra. The show was organized to bring together the two groups whose comedy videos have become very popular.
The curtain raiser for the show was a performance by some up-and-coming hip-life artists, including Buddy Brown and Chris White. Some kids were also selected from the audience to battle each other in a dancing competition. Then came the talented kids stars Tutu Lapatu and Awal, who also entertained the crowd. It was now the time for Calibos, Emanuela and Mark Angel to do what they do best.
Do you know Calibos?
Yes, the Calibos is only one S.
What happened to the other S?
Do step big here.
Oh, big. We serve everybody. No matter how they treat, I'll serve you.
Yes, customer. We serve everybody. Even most of our customers here are pigs.
Yes, and all these people that are here now, they are pigs.
Now so.
We next year.
Come on.
Thank you, Thomas. And that has been News Hour on GBC 24. Thank you for watching.